Dove per me? E dai, certo, la possibilità, vede gomma, è giusto. State, aspettate.
Thank you. A ver. Hola, hola, captain, hola, captain.
Yeah. Thank you.
πάρει βασιλάρα μου.
Πόδια. Πόδια κάτω. Πάμε.
Λίγο.
Back with another Kirby the Rainbow video. I decided that the rug wasn't that good of a test because it didn't really have that much of a pile and the agitation was just outrageous, and so I just want to try it on this pretty push all in test. I'm just gonna vacuum until I don't hear it picking up anything else. I'm gonna do it multiple directions just to be sure. Water, but I guess it doesn't really matter since we have this. So I'm just gonna turn the rainbow on and let's get started. I can hear it picking that stuff. My last little passes and I'll be done. Let's do a swivel. I love that. So we come over here and look at this. I think this is a lot better results for the test. You can see it.
Yeah.
Όχι, έχει άλλο παιχνίδι μετά. Φιλικό.
Όχι, άλλο.
Έχει φιλικό. Ποιες ομάδες σαν.
Thank you.
Κωστά, πάρε και εσύ ένα τέτοιο ρε να παίζεις. Που κάθεσαι και κοιτάς όλοι μου.
Gracias. Thank you.
Let's go.
$200 Shark Rotator Pro Liftaway Vacuum Cleaner. This vacuum cleaner has a removable wand that doubles as the handle. It has different brush attachments, and it can actually be turned into a canister vacuum. You can just lift out the bin and take it wherever you want to go. That makes the Shark actually the most versatile of all of the five vacuums we tested in the set. And that says a lot since it's the cheapest. Like the others, it has a clear bin so you can see how full it is. It's easy to remove and incredibly easy to clean. It also comes with a HEPA filter like the others, and it rotates very well, and it even has two headlights, which is kind of cute. At $200, this is by far the least expensive vacuum that we tested in this group. The Dyson DC41 is actually $650, so we wanted to see how a $200 vacuum cleaner with similar features would stack up to the Dyson. I like the design and construction of this vacuum cleaner better than either of the Dysons we tested, but not quite as much as the Oreck or the Electrolux. All right, let's talk performance. Instead of a Shark's regular fare of fish and hapless surfers, we decided to test this one against Cheerios, pet hair, a mix of sand and sawdust, nuts, bolts, washers, and human hair. So how does the Shark do on dry land? Overall, it did pretty well on every test. It didn't do great picking up sand and sawdust from our thinnest carpet. It also didn't do great picking up pet hair from hardwood floors. Although the Shark didn't pick up most of the pet hair on the hardwood surface, if you turn the brush on, it collects everything. Some folks might think that that will scuff up the floor or scatter some of the particles, but it did work. So if you're willing to take that risk, it will collect all of the pet hair on your bare floors. But it did a great job picking up Cheerios, it did a great job picking up human hair, and it did a great job picking up pet hair from both the thinner and thicker carpet surfaces. It did pick up a few bobby pins, washers, and nuts, but most of them actually got stuck in the brush. So for $200, the Shark is an incredibly good vacuum cleaner. It didn't quite stand up to some of the others on performance, but for its price, you're getting a great value. I'm Megan Woolerton for CNET, and this has been a review of the Shark Rotator Pro Liftaway Vacuum. Watch out, more expensive models. Shark is coming.
Hola, hola, mami.
Ξέρει να δουλεύει τώρα. Τον λένε όλοι, τον λένε.
Bravo.